All right, NBA playoffs, the Brooklyn Nets on the road at the Milwaukee Bucks. Let me take you out to Pfizer Forum for game four action in this one. The Bucks fans having a good time in downtown Milwaukee. Second quarter, Giannis Antetokounmpo, the Greek freak, takes the ball, boom, and slams in two of his 34 points. 37-36, Milwaukee. Still second quarter, Kyrie Irving in the lane. He scores, but he comes down the wrong way on the layup, landing with a leg injury. Bucks 107, Nets 96, your final. Nets coach Steve Nash says x-rays taken on Kyrie's ankle were negative. The series is tied two games each. The best of two out of three, game five, Tuesday in Brooklyn. HBCU Baseball. Alexander Weitz with the Minority Baseball Prospects joins us on this BNC Sports exclusive. Check out part three. Had the opportunity to go to the museum. Talk about that experience, and when you see somebody's jersey, a Birmingham Black Baron, or you see the jersey of somebody like a Jackie Robinson, or a trailblazer, if you will, and we think about people like hammering Hank Aaron, and the list goes on. Talk about that legacy and what that means to you personally.
It's so big, just dealing with minorities right now. Just so much they had to overcome, and how big black baseball was, you know, through the economy. The Negro Leagues was probably the biggest black moneymaker, you know, in the country. So it was big just to see those guys and see where they came from, and really just show these college guys, where it all begun, you know, how America was built and how we can continue to, you know, progress through the game of baseball.
For parents out there and for young people who want to get involved with baseball or softball, they want to come back to the diamond, so to speak, what do you tell people to do, and what's a good age to start out at?
You know, the youngest age, T-ball, around 3 to 4. The earlier you can get kids, you know, into the game of baseball, I think a lot of time with minorities, we it's a skill-set game. And a lot of time with minorities, we try to wait too late. You know, the biggest thing with the game of baseball is really getting these kids acclimated to the game of baseball around 4 to 5.
All right, thank you, sir. That is Alexander Weitz with Minority Baseball Prospects. All right, Major League Baseball, the pro baseball community is mourning the life and times of former two-time baseball all-star pitcher, the ace, Jim Mudcat Grant. According to the Minnesota Twins, quote, the entire Minnesota Twins organization is saddened by the death of former pitcher Jim Mudcat Grant, who passed away at the age of 85, end quote. Grant is the first black pitcher to win 20 games in the American League. He's also the first black pitcher to win a World Series game, folks. The ace, Jim Mudcat Grant, is gone at age 85. He will surely be missed. Finally, it's time for our King of the Hill. He captured a gold medal in boxing as a light welterweight champion during the 1976 Olympics up in Montreal, Quebec. Sugar Ray Leonard is our BNC King of the Hill. Ray Charles Leonard was born May 17th, 1956 in Wilmington, North Carolina. He was the first boxer to earn over $100 million from prize fighting purses. In 40 bouts, Sugar Ray Leonard's record is 36-3-1 with 25 knockouts. Sugar Ray Leonard captured 6 world championships in 5 different weight classes. Sugar Ray Leonard continues to be a super duper legend in the boxing game. Sugar Ray Leonard is our BNC King of the Hill. We will be right back after this.